low cystine and sulfate, mid-range methionine, and high homocysteine. What to do about it?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. James says, what are some causes and what should one do about low cystine and sulfate levels, in particular given slightly elevated homocysteine and mid-range methionine? Well, if your homocysteine, I mean, let's start with the methionine. So if your methionine's mid-range, then it would seem that your recycling of methionine, of homocysteine and methionine, is adequate. Now you could quibble with that because there's multiple things going in and out here. But my default position on this would be you probably don't have a problem recycling homocysteine and methionine. And that might explain why, as I'm assuming this is in the fasting state, your homocysteine is only slightly elevated. Now, if you mean by slightly elevated, if you mean slightly elevated outside of the lab's reference range, then that's very elevated. And so I would look at that a little bit differently. But, you know, especially when paired with the low cystine and sulfate levels, it sounds like you have a low rate of the transsulfuration pathway or the CBS enzyme, which is the first step in that pathway, which takes homocysteine down to cysteine, which then can be metabolized to sulfate. And if that's the case, you need to look at potential causes of that. But the top ones would be, well, actually, you know what? I've done some. So the one that everyone thinks about is vitamin B6, but I did a little bit of making some notes on some research. So I know there's a couple other nutrients that are involved here. So let me pull up my notes. Okay, so CBS, it depends on heme iron as well as vitamin B6. And it also uses serine, which interconverts with glycine. So I would look at your serine and glycine levels. Because if those are low, they could be compromising the CBS reaction. And I would look at your iron status and, you know, look at a CBC and make sure your hemoglobin levels are normal. The heme iron in this enzyme is not the same as hemoglobin, but they both depend on heme synthesis. And actually, if you're running low in glycine, that would compromise your heme synthesis as well. So would it be the case if you were low on B6? And B6 itself is needed for the CBS reaction. So if you're low in glycine B6, you're probably going to be low in heme iron, even regardless of your iron status, just because of compromising heme synthesis. So serine, glycine, iron, and B6 are all very big things to look at. It is activated by S-adenosyl methionine. So even if your methionine's mid-range, I would look at your SAMe levels. So that would require getting the de novo methylation panel, which looks at methionine and S-adenosyl methionine, because if that's blocked, then that could lead to poor activation of CBS, even if your heme iron, B6, serine, and glycine are all adequate. And in that case, that would make me reinterpret the mid-range methionine levels, because if your methionine to S-adenosyl methionine conversion is blocked, then that should make your methionine levels high. And so if they're mid-range, then I would, in that circumstance, I would change my interpretation away from recycling of homocysteine to methionine is inadequate. And then I would then say, well, actually, if they're only mid-range despite the block in converting methionine to S-adenosyl methionine, you must have poor recycling of homocysteine to methionine on top of everything else I just said, because otherwise your you know, if you didn't, your methionine levels would be high. So CBS converts homocysteine to cystathionine, and then the next enzyme, CGL, converts cystathionine to cysteine. And cysteine is the individual amino acid. Cystine, which is what you had measured, is the disulfide of that amino acid. CGL uses vitamin B6 again. And so, is there anything? Just vitamin B6. But diabetes and methylglyoxal have been shown to be factors that decrease its expression, and age increases its expression. So I guess if you were a young diabetic, you would have the worst CGL activity. Methylglyoxal is a whole big Pandora's box, so I kind of want to leave it there unless people have questions about that. But basically, poor metabolic control would compromise the conversion of cystathionine to cysteine. And then you have, you know, so if your cystine is low, then you're probably looking at these two upstream enzymes, which are CBS and CGL. But if the sulfate is similarly low as the cysteine, then there's probably no need for further explanation because sulfate is made from cysteine. But if the sulfate's a lot lower than the cysteine is, then I would look at things even downstream from the cysteine. So CDO is the next enzyme that oxidizes cysteine to cysteine sulfinic acid on the way to taurine and sulfate. And CDO requires iron. And then on the way to sulfate, you're going to come across sulfite, which requires molybdenum to get to sulfate. So I guess that was a lot. Let me see if I can summarize this. So number one, look at whether methionine is being converted to SAMe. If it's being converted to SAMe well, then it's probably the case that your folate and B12 and choline recycling of homocysteine to methionine is fine. If it's not, then you probably need to work on that, although that's not going to explain the cysteine and sulfate being low. If that conversion is blocked, it being blocked could be driven by low magnesium, low ATP, or genetics, and you probably won't be able to activate the conversion of homocysteine to cysteine and sulfate without fixing that. And if you can't fix that with magnesium and metabolic control and improvement in ATP levels, then you are probably going to have to rely on SAMe supplementation. If the methionine to SAMe is not blocked, then you don't need to worry about that. Assuming you fixed that or it wasn't a problem in the first place, then to get homocysteine to cysteine and sulfate, you're looking at serine, glycine, vitamin B6, iron, and molybdenum. All right. Thank you, James, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.